Hello friends, welcome to yet another video of our Google Cloud Platform Beginner Series. This is the fourth video in this series, and in this video, we'll do a hands-on exercise to learn how we can create a container and deploy it on Google Cloud Platform. So the next, we will go onto my laptop and see how exactly it is done. But before that, if you haven't subscribed the channel, please go and subscribe and hit the bell icon.
So friends, before going ahead with our hands-on exercise, we have to cover a few basics which we'll try to cover in a few slides quickly. So this video is not about covering the fundamentals of containers. If you want to understand the core fundamentals of containerization technology, there is a separate video which I have created. So go check that out. I'll give the link of that video in the description below. So go check that out. Let's understand what we will cover today. So first, we will understand container basics. This would be a quick overview. Then we'll understand the containerization process, how a containerization process works. Then we will understand what all components we have used in this demonstration. And finally, we'll see the demo. Container basics. So in a very simple term, containerization technology is a method to package an application within a capsule with all its dependencies. So it becomes kind of an independent entity which can be shipped from one environment to another environment. You can see in the architecture diagram how the physical hardware and the physical infrastructure is hosted on the server. Then on top of it, there is a host OS, and on top of it, there is a Docker engine. This Docker engine does the magic of wrapping various applications into containers. Those containers can then be shipped with minimal dependencies across platforms. So this is a very, very basic understanding of containers. So what is a containerization process? So basically, there are five simple steps to understand how containerization works, and these five simple steps we will follow in our exercise as well. So let's understand how. So the first step what we will follow is we will code our application. So basically, in order to containerize something, first you have to develop your application. So at step one, we'll create a simple application by writing code. After that comes the Docker file. Now this Docker file is a static file with a set of instructions to instruct the Docker engine about the dependencies which are required for this particular application to run within a container. So this Docker file combined with this application then is used in step three, which is to build a container image. So a container image can only be built once we have our application code along with the Docker file with all the instructions. The step four is to push this particular container image onto a container registry. So this container registry is a shared pool of various container images, and you can continuously use this registry as a common pool for storing all your container images, and you can push the images into this registry and also pull the images from this registry as well. And finally, when you want to run this particular container, you will do it on this particular technology, which is in step five, you will do it under Cloud Run. So Cloud Run is a stateless, fully managed application provided by Google Cloud specifically to run containerized applications. So we'll understand that in detail once we go into the demo, but this is a high level overview of how a specific containerization process works. It might vary from case to case slightly, but overall this is the process which we will follow today. So now we will understand what are the basic components used in this exercise. Obviously, there might be some components you are aware of, some component which you might hear for the first time, but the thing is, once you understand a basic, you can always go back and do your homework. So first of all, we'll use Python to code our application. We'll write a very simple application like Hello World, and then we will use Cloud Shell. Now what is Cloud Shell? Cloud Shell is kind of a lightweight Linux virtual machine which runs within your Google Cloud platform, and you can use it for running any application or for creating any containers, because it comes with all the pre-installed utilities like gcloud, which is a command line utility. Also, you have Docker installed already in this particular shell, so you don't need to do those prerequisite. If you want to do it on your machine, then you have to install Google Cloud SDK. Now Google Cloud SDK has to be installed first. You have to install then all the utilities coming with that SDK to further use this process. But we will save time and we'll directly use Cloud Shell in this particular case. Docker file, as I said, it contains a set of commands to be used for building Docker container image. Finally, the container image would be the file with all the executable and the application code, which will then be pushed into container registry. Now, container registry, as I said, is a shared repository for storing images. Cloud Run also is a fully managed service to run containerized replication, as we have already understood. We will also be using Flask. So what is Flask? Flask is a web framework, very lightweight web framework written in Python, which can help you create a very lightweight web application like a blog or a wiki page. So we will use Flask in this because we are creating a very, very lightweight application. Unicorn is Green Unicorn, and it is an HTTP server which comes in Unix. So we will use this particular HTTP server to deploy our application, and we will access it via this particular HTTP server. WSGI stands for Web Service Gateway Interface. So it is basically deploying any kind of web service or web applications. G-Cloud, as I said, it's a command line interface tool used for managing Google Cloud products and services. So it's time for the demo. So let's start. So first, I will log into my Google Cloud console. Now there are some basic steps which we have to follow, which will include certain Linux commands as well. If you are not well versed with Linux, these are very basic commands which I'll explain over the course of few minutes while we are performing this exercise. But if you want me to make a separate video on basic Linux commands, do let me know. I'll try to make something for you. But these are very basic commands which you should know, and these are used in day-to-day work for Unix. So pretty much whatever you do on your Google Cloud platform would start by creating a project. If you already have a project, well and good. But if you have not, which I have intentionally not created yet because I wanted to show you guys. So first thing is you have to create a project. Whatever you do, whatever resources you will utilize, whatever billing will or charges will occur based on the usage you do within this project. So let's create our project. So let's create a new project. Let me name it as YouTube Container Demo. So this is my project name, YouTube Container Demo. So I'll create this. So guys, now our project is ready, and this is the dashboard which shows overall activity of our dashboard. And just to let you know, this is my demo account, so I have got $300 credit which I can utilize, and you can also create your own account using the 1 year trial period. So now what we have to do is, as I told you in our slides, that we will do all our activity using a cloud shell, which is a lightweight virtual machine running within this platform to help us run certain basic command line utilities for which we don't need to install or configure Docker or install Google Cloud SDK. We can simply click on this icon which says activate cloud shell. So we'll click on this, and just to let you know, I have opened this intentionally in incognito so that you know there is no history or of previous Google accounts used. So better to use this way. Now this particular cloud shell is opening up for my project. All right, so you can click on this icon and open it in the separate window because that would be much easier. So now you can see I am logged into my cloud shell. You can see my user ID and the project name we have just created. So first thing what we will do is create a new directory using mkdir command. And this name of this directory would be similar to what we are trying to achieve. So I'm trying to create a Hello YouTube application based on Python language. So I'll name it Hello YouTube Python. So now I'll go into this directory using cd command. And I have just clicked on tab, which auto completes the location, so you don't need to type it. So just keep a note of these are Linux shortcuts. So now we are into the directory. So first thing which we have to do is to code our app, right? As per our first step, we have to code our app. Obviously, this is not a coding exercise. So the code which I'm using is a very simple code, which is already built. And I'll show you what it is. We'll go through the functionality of that code, and we'll then create it. So we'll create a new file, app.py. Okay, so for that the command which we use is touch. Okay, so touch creates a new file. So I'll do app.py. So now I should have app.py in here. Okay, so now we have it. What we have to now do is to open this file and enter the content of the code which we want to run. So it's a Python code. So we will use Nano editor. So Nano is a editor. It is kind of an editor to edit any file or enter any data, modify any data in any file. So I just copy this, paste it here, enter. Okay, so now I'll just take the code. All right, so let's first understand quickly what this particular code is trying to do. As I told you, this is importing certain modules and certain classes into this code. So the most important one is Flask. As I said, we are trying to create a web application here. So Flask is the web framework which enables us to do so. So all this code which we are trying to do is based on what we are trying to achieve. So we have used a function called as route. This will route our application. When we'll hit and click on our application, it will route it to our root directory. And this is the definition of the function which we have created. So this is the function which we have created, hello YouTube. These are the variables which we have created, and this is the return format. So what it will do when we'll hit it, it will give us a message called as hello YouTube, which you can see in here under debug mode on the local host, and the port should be 8080. So we'll run this application on port 8080. So basically this functionality will run a web server. On that web server, it will deploy this application, and this application will run on port 8080 and give us a message, hello YouTube. So now I will save this. So I'll click Control X. So now it will ask me whether I have to modify it. I'll say yes, Y, and I'll enter. So now I have the code inside this file. Now I will have to create a Docker file. As I said, the step two is to create a Docker file. Now I will again create Docker file. So the syntax for Docker file we'll see in few seconds. So we'll do touch Docker file. So now we have the Docker file. So we'll do nano. Now, as I said, Docker file is a set of instruction which tells a container actually what you want to run and what are its dependencies, which should be shipped along with that application code, which will help run that application. So you can quickly see what I have added some comments also to make it self-explanatory, but just for our understanding. So basically this application is a Python application. So how you will run it without a Python environment? So first thing what a container will do is it will understand this Docker file, and it will understand that okay, I need to get Python 3.7 version in order to run this application. Secondly, this Docker file will tell that from where you have to copy the code. So the local code which we have just created, app.py, it has mentioned that okay, this particular work directory needs to be checked, and then this particular code needs to be copied. Third is to install Flask Unicorn, which is the web HTTP web server coming with Unix. So this is the command. Pip install is a generic command to install any software. So we will run this command inside this Docker file. This Docker file will send this instruction once the image is getting created. And finally, we will execute this. You can see we will execute this web server. We will bind the port which is there in the application. So what port we have given? We have given port 8080. And we have defined that when this particular web server will start, it will only have one worker process, and that worker process will have 8 threads within. If we want to increase or decrease the capacity of this server, then we can do so. But it's just for demonstration, so we are going with the minimal configuration. Now both my files are ready, but one important thing is now I have to change the execution mode. So chmod is the command to change the execution mode of a file. So right now if I do ls-lrt, which will show me the list of the file, you can see that these two files are there, but this Docker file is not executable. We have to make it executable so that, you know, this can be executed while creating an image. So what I'll do, I'll type chmod plus x and then the file name. Okay, now if I do so, now you can see that this particular file is now executable. Okay, so now we have what we have done so far. We have created our application code, we have created our Docker file, both are now ready. So at step three, we have to now build the container image. So now what we have to do, we have to use container build command to build the image. So what is that command? So now the gcloud utility will come into picture. So we will type gcloud submit hyphen hyphen tag gcr.io. now gcr.io is the container registry tag under which this particular application will be installed. Now after that, the syntax is you have to give the project ID. After gcr.io, you have to give the project ID. So where is the project ID? You can find it through a command, but I'll give you an easy way of doing it. So if you go to your dashboard, you will see the project ID here. Okay, so this is your project ID. So I'll put the project ID, and then I have to put what tag I want to attach or associate with this particular image. So this particular tag, with this particular tag, this particular image will be built. So I will give it hello YouTube. This would be my tag. Okay. So now I will hit enter and it will go and it will start to use the application and the Docker file to start creating a container image, and then it will try to push it into this particular location, which is a container registry. So basically we are doing step 3 and step 4 right now, building an image and then try to push it into a container registry. So I'll hit enter. So now you can see that it is trying to upload the image. So it is asking, would you like to enable and retry this? So always remember this, guys, that everything pretty much which you do on Google Cloud is running under an API. So until unless that API is enabled, you won't be able to use that. Suppose you want to use a VM, you want to spin up a VM, you have to enable the Compute Engine API. So it's not possible for us to enable it right from the beginning. So gcloud will automatically prompt you if you need any APIs which are not enabled. So I'll put Y here. So it will enable the cloud build API, which is required to build this container. Now it is saying enabling service. So you can see the message starting build. Now it has started to build this image. Okay. And you can see all the data. You can see the steps in the Docker file, which we have mentioned. Now it is trying to use those steps. Step 2, step 3, like this. Now it is downloading Flask. As I said, we have told this particular container to involve these softwares and libraries. So it is doing that. Now it is trying to push it. So the build is successfully built, means the image is now successfully built. Now it is trying to push this image onto the container registry. And this is what it is trying to push, which we created. And now you can see the message. So now it has been pushed. So now this is status. So now status is success, and it is clearly telling us that it took 37 seconds, and this is the source file. So first it packaged that file into a tar file, and then it deployed this particular image on the container registry. So now we have this container image ready. Now if we want to see whether whether it has been successfully deployed or not, you can do it by cross validating it. So GS means Google Cloud Storage. Okay, so it has been stored. So let's verify once if we have seen if we are seeing something on the Google Cloud Storage. This is just for your information, it's not required, but this is just for information. So we'll go to cloud storage. Yes, so one is this particular this particular location, and another is this one. So one is the image which has been stored, and another is actually the application, okay, which has been uploaded now under a container. Okay, so if you go under this one, so you can see the folder source, and you can see the this is the tar file which was created. Similarly, the other one contains the actual application. Now the last step remains is running and deploying. So for that we a cloud run application will come into picture. So let's do that. The command for that is again starting with gcloud run deploy image. So this is the image tag. Now I have to give the location of the image. Again we have to give so I'll copy the project ID, and then our tag was hello YouTube. Okay, this was the tag, if you remember. So now this is the image which we are trying to run and deploy using cloud run. It will give us the options, we'll select what we have to. So let's hit enter. So see, it asks you like what is the target platform, where you want to. This is an image, it can run anywhere. So where you want to run, so we are using cloud run because it's a fully managed service, so we don't have to configure anything. We have an image, we can quickly use it because it is a managed service provided by Google Cloud. So I will enter 1 to select cloud run. Now I'll to simply enter here. There's nothing, it is just simply asking whether I want to specify any platform managed command, but that's fine, we'll just enter here, it is not required. We'll click here because we have to now enable Google APIs again. and you can see it is run.google.api. So now the run API is coming into picture. So now it is enabling the service. Now I have to select a region, because definitely this particular service needs to run, this particular application or container application needs to run in some region. So I'll enter 5 and select Europe West 4. I'll select yes in this. We don't need any other thing here. And see, now we are deploying the new service. You can see here, okay? So now the container image is being utilized, and now a container is actually getting deployed. So you can see all the commands which are coming in, all the status updates which are coming in are self-explanatory. So now you can see deploying container to cloud run service. Hello YouTube. In project YouTube container demo region. Everything is very clear from the logs. Wow. So now we have deployed successfully the container image. Okay. And it is saying done. Service hello YouTube revision number this has been deployed and is serving 100% of traffic. So now this is the testing time. Let's see if we have done it correctly. So we have to click this link. Now your container application is running. It is running a web server, and this web server should now be accessible, and it should display the message which we have developed in our code. So I'll click on this. Wow. So now it says hello YouTube, and this is great. So now we have successfully deployed the hello YouTube application, and it is running successfully fine. Let's go to our cloud platform and see whether we see anything happening on the traffic front. So you can see that some activity has started happening, because we have now deployed these APIs which are now coming into action. So definitely these APIs will show us some logs and traffic which is coming through. So you can see that all these APIs are now running and coming into use. So that means that, you know, we are getting response perfectly fine onto this hello YouTube. We can also try to do it in another way of you know, copying this URL once, and maybe try to open a new browser, a normal Chrome browser, and hit it from there. Yes. And this is perfect. I think we have now deployed a container application. It is running correctly. It is running perfectly. And this is exactly what I wanted to show you in this video. So friends, just to recap. So we coded our app, we created a Docker file, we built our container image, we pushed the container image to the container registry, and then we deployed and ran this container image on Cloud Run. So we have done all the 5 steps successfully, and now we have a running web application, hello YouTube. If you want to learn any other concept in this manner for Google Cloud Platform, do let me know. So hope you like this video. Please don't forget to share this with your friends, and also subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon for more. Thank you so much. And keep hustling.